It's time for your daily crypto update with the Framework Fortune Investing Shorts channel. Bitcoin is still holding over this trend and is actually forming a little consolidation triangle right here in this 58,000 area. We already have this line of support there that we're looking to hold. That support did hold. And if Bitcoin can break up over this little downtrend, this little triangle that it's made, then we could see it move up to that 59,000, maybe even 60 or over. The previous high was 65,000. So there is a possibility, as long as we keep having these nice movements, these big leg ups, and then this little bit of consolidation triangle or U-shape, whatever we get, if we keep having that nice healthy movement on the way up, we could test 65,000. And then if it breaks that, then who knows? Ether still looking very nice, broke out of this triangle here. We can take that little line out, and then we can see this area should hold as some support if it comes back down, but it is still on its bull run, getting hung up right below 3,000. If Ethereum can break over 3,000, that could be a massive rip coming. If it doesn't, which more than likely, I don't see it doing that, at least at the current moment, then it'll probably come back down to this 2800, maybe 2650 area. I'm your host, Ben, and we're doing today's update a little bit different. So instead of doing 1 minute video clips, I'm doing this all together in one video of the cryptos I'm looking at for today. If you prefer me to keep doing the 1 minute videos or maybe do a mix of both for cryptos on this channel, then let me know that as well. But let's not waste any time. I appreciate all the support. And if you haven't checked out our home channel, Framework Fortune, go check it out. Dogecoin, the maniac favorite coin of everybody on the internet, is building a big triangle on this chart. You can see we have these pivot points where we've attached it to now. It looks like it's running into some resistance in this 40 cent area. It did run into that 40 cent area resistance before and had got held up. If Dogecoin starts to break this trend line, we could see it make new highs maybe above. We can see it make new highs up to that 50 cent level like I'm thinking. So if you got in Matic early in the week and you capitalized on this, good job. This did have a little bit of a fake out breakout, didn't break up that high. I said a dollar was going to be pretty strong resistance. So we had a rejection at 95 cents and it's still on this downtrend. The downtrend has kind of broken there, but you just have to move it over at this point. And then you can see we still have a downtrend that it has to break. It's trying to find support in this 78 cent area. If we delete these trend lines of this old triangle, we now have a down triangle, a descending triangle. So until it breaks back above that, it will remain bearish short term until it finds a new area of support. Dash I talked about yesterday as one of my picks. Right now, Dash is testing this resistance area that I've been saying it would. And you can see it's having some issues. Now, we do have a triangle that has formed here. So Dash has a chance today to break up out of this triangle and make its next leg up to maybe this 350 area. If it does not break out of this triangle, it's probably going to come back down to the 300 area, find support there before it can turn around and keep moving up. Litecoin we talked about in the beginning of the week. Bitcoin is running, so Litecoin is running too. It broke out of this big triangle, so we can take that downtrend out of there. And we are running into some resistance in this 275 area. It got held up multiple times back here at 275, held up here, here, and here. So it needs to break that and hold above it. 275 needs to start acting as new support. If 275 holds as support, then we could see Litecoin all the way up to $300. And then if it breaks that even higher, possibly up to a new high here in the next couple of weeks. But today's story, we have another coin that I haven't heard much about. I have seen a little bit on this one, OKB. It's been getting a little attention, but it's been on a nice trend line since February from $766 all the way up to $33. Very bullish. We look at it in the short term, we're way above this resistance that broke that triangle resistance of this downtrend. So there's a couple of places support could find itself. It's trying to find itself at 34, but it is struggling. You can see buyers have pushed it up multiple times when it dropped below there because of these extended candle wicks. But this candle here is a little sketchy. So depending on what happens by the end of the night, this will either drop back down to this $30 area, or it will make another curl up and maybe we see new highs up to 40 by tomorrow or the next day. But I would expect more of a pullback than this little pullback myself personally, because this is a pretty giant move in a very short time span. So people who are in back here on this trend line, if they're not hodling, they've already probably gotten out of this because that would have been a massive gain. New buyers are going to have to come in at these price levels to hold up this support. If new buyers don't think that this token is worth this much, then they won't come in until the value is lower to where they want to buy it at. So it will depend on the next few days what happens with OKB. Now, waves we've been covering as well. Waves with continuing to make moves up. Currently, right now, though, it looks like we may have a head and shoulders pattern at this resistance area of 23.5. You can see where multiple candles have hit. This one broke above it, but was immediately pushed down by a bunch of selling. So a head and shoulders pattern is basically you have this head right here, you have a shoulder here, you have a shoulder here, and usually this right here will turn into the other arm, but in the reverse direction. This big candle here would be your arm. So we would see another big red candle down as an arm to finish out this head and shoulders pattern. And we could see this back down to 18, maybe even 17. But short term, I'm bearish on waves at the current moment until the support area confirms and holds.